G'day folks, Ben from Stones here today with the companion single zone 60 litre fridge freezer. This is a tough and affordable freezer with simple design and plenty of room inside for those who are looking for an all-round fridge for their camping expeditions. Now this 60 litre version weighs about 23 kilos. Measurements, which include the handles on the ends, are about 66 centimetres in length, about 52 centimeters in depth, and that includes the latches and the hinge on the back here, and about 57 centimeters in height, 57 and a half to the very top here. Having a look at the outside of the fridge, this dark gray component here on the top and the sides is a metal. There's plastic components on the corners here and around the top of the hinge. If I just spin around to the end here, we can see we've got nice heavy duty handles with a sort of a nylon plastic grab portion in the middle there. Just a quick look at the back, we can see there's plastic components covering the hinges at the back here, but nothing much more to see there. Bit of a vent down where the compressor is at the bottom there. Flick it back around to the front. Once again, not a lot to see. Nice heavy duty latches here to hold it down. Big latches that are really secure. At the bottom, we've got the control panel here, which we'll go into a little bit more shortly. Vent below that because the compressor is in the bottom here. And then we have a look at the last side here where, once again, another handle here, spring-loaded handle. Vents over the top of the compressor here. And this is where we can power it up. Now, while we're down here, we'll talk about the compressor that's inside these because it's a brand of compressor that we haven't seen in fridges a lot. It's an LG dual speed compressor inside of here. I guess we haven't seen a lot of it in fridges recently, but it is a reputable brand, so I think we can be pretty confident that this compressor is going to last just as well as most of the other compressors we see in the market. Now, to power it up, there is a 12 and 240 volt input here. Now, you can power it from 12 or 24 volt. You can power it from 12 or 24 volt, or you can also power it from 240 volt. You get a 12 volt cable included with it, which is this one here. That plugs into the same port as the 240 volt, and it does have a little cap on the end there that you can remove to turn it into either a merit or a cigarette plug. And then you get this 240 volt adapter here, which plugs into the same port here, which we'll do now. And I'm going to plug this into 240 volt power source at the other end here so we can fire it up and I can show you the controls. Now I've got that plugged into the 240 volt power source. Now there is an instruction manual that comes with your fridge. The instruction manual covers all the different volumes or different sizes in this range, but the basic settings are the same, and that will go into a little bit more detail than what I'll cover today. But when we first plug it in, it beeps, and this panel here goes back to the last setting you had it on. So if I had this switched on when I last unplugged it from the power source, when I plug it back in, this panel will automatically go on. But in this instance, I had it switched off. I plugged it in, so it's gone back into the last setting I had. So the fridge is still off at the moment. So to turn this on, we just press the button here and our display lights up. Now there's a few different things going on here. If we jump on the top left here, there's a battery indicator. Now that's an indicator of the power or the voltage that's being supplied at the input to the fridge. When that's full, it's about 12.5 volts or above when we're using a 12 volt supply. If it's right down on one bar here, there's probably less than 10 volts going in. So it's a good indication of the battery power that's, if you've got it connected to a battery, how much power is left in the battery to supply the fridge. This is telling us the current temperature inside the fridge here, not the set temperature, but the current temperature. We've only just turned this on, so that's still got to cool down. Below that, we've got battery protection. Now, there's three different levels of battery protection, and the manual will let you know the voltages that these are set at or this cuts out at. So check your manual to work out which of those you want it set on, but we just press the battery protection button here to scroll between high, low, and medium. And just below that is three little words that change. Secondly, there is a compressor speed. It's eco and max. Max we can use to cool the fridge down really quickly, but once it's reached its temperature, it's best kept on eco because it's going to draw less current. The average current draw for this fridge is about 1.1 amps, so it's pretty good for a fridge of this size. Now the last feature I haven't talked about on the panel here is the actual temperature setting here. There's a plus and a minus, which if we press this temperature here, it goes to a flashing setting where we can flick up and down to choose the setting that we want inside the fridge. Now that's anywhere from minus 20 to plus 20 degrees. I'm going to set it on say 5 degrees. It'll flash and then it'll revert back to the actual temperature inside the fridge. If I click this across to max now, the compressor will speed up and it'll bring that temperature down much quicker. So I'm gonna leave that running like that and we'll see how quickly that temperature comes down now. Now this control panel is located on the front right hand or bottom right hand corner here for easy access. So if you've got this mounted in your vehicle this way to access it from the front, this is easily viewable, easily operated, rather than it being over the back of the fridge or in a spot that's hard to reach. Let's jump up over the top and have a look inside the fridge now. Now this lid here is actually sort of spring loaded, or they call it soft close, but there's a bit of an assisted open there. There's metal hinges at the back here you can see that are covered by those plastic covers we saw. And the insulation around here is about 6.5 centimeters, so it's nice thick PU foam insulation. If we have another look up at the lid here, there's a nice thick seal that runs around the top here. To make sure that the cold air is sealed inside the fridge. And it's fairly flat on top here, a bit of sort of ridges. I'm not exactly sure what these are for, but this doesn't dip down inside the fridge too far, so you can use most of the internal height. If we have a look inside, there is a removable basket. This is all a one-piece basket. If we take this out, you can see it's got a shape to fit inside the fridge. So this is the step that covers the step inside here where the compressor sits underneath. I can feel the sides of this are really cold already, especially around the top there because it's cooling down. And dimensions inside the fridge, we've got 49.5 centimeters from edge to edge here, about 35.5 centimeters in width here. Now the deepest section here is about 42 centimeters from the base to this edge here, which is going to be roughly where the lid sort of comes into, and then 24 centimeters from the top of this shelf here to the same edge here. Now you need to take a little bit off of those measurements because you're going to put the basket inside, so you probably need to take about a centimeter off the total width and depth and height to allow for that basket width. Having a look inside around the front here, hopefully you can see this, there is an LED light to help us see in the dark. And there's also another little panel down here. You don't really need to pull this out, but you can undo that. And that's just got the little temperature gauge inside there. So I guess you can replace that if need be. I don't know why you'd need to. It's tucked away under a little plastic cover there. So it measures the temperature nice and deep inside the fridge. Now, in terms of can you fit bottles inside, I'll put the basket inside here. There's tons of height inside the fridge here. So with that basket in there, I've got just a regular soft drink bottle there, heaps of room there. We can fit that with a bit of room on top. We've got a champagne bottle here as well, which is not quite as high as the soft drink bottle here. So even a Riesling bottle, which is usually a bit taller, is gonna fit inside there really easily. So you've got 60 liters volume in total, which is a really good balance for a family camping fridge. A good balance anyway between volume inside and the actual size of the fridge to fit it inside the car. Have a quick look at the control panel down here. While we're on the front, it's dropped down to 15 degrees. Now the lid's actually only been shut for a few minutes, but it's been running probably for 10 to 15. So it has managed to pull the temperature down, and the sides inside the fridge feel really cold. Should also mention too that this is only really designed to be installed inside a car or inside a caravan, not in a weather exposed area. Accessories that come with it. I've showed you everything that comes with the fridge itself. There's no nutserts on the bottom, so you can't sort of permanently install it anywhere like inside a vehicle. There's no readily available fridge slide, so you're going to have to find an aftermarket fridge slide, and you're just going to have to rely on the handles on the side here to tie it down to whatever you mount it to. And you can get a fridge cover that goes with it. You don't need it. This is going to offer a bit more efficiency and a bit of protection to the fridge. It also offers a little bit more storage. So put your fridge inside here. It's got panels so the compressor can breathe. This is a clear panel where the control panel sits. And then you've got a couple of storage things on the front here for your cables or whatever you want to store at the front of your fridge. That is pretty much all the features of the Companion 60 liter fridge freezer. A really affordable option for maybe occasional family campers who aren't looking to install it on the back of the or have a permanent installation in their car. They want to put it in and out the car. Also a great option for say Christmas Day when you want extra space for those cold drinks. You can check out more details on this guy online at snowys.com.au, where you'll find it at our lowest prices every day. Got any questions though, let us know down in the comments below. Subscribe to our channel for all of our latest and greatest information, or check out some other Companion products like these ones down here.